Question number 26. What is the key characteristic of a structure-based testing technique? Structure-based techniques are also known as white box testing techniques. Answer A. They are mainly used to assess the structure of the specification. This one could be confusing, but it's wrong. We use our knowledge of the system structure to create test cases and test the system, not to evaluate whether the structure is good or not. So answer A is wrong. Answer B. They are based on the skills and experience of the tester. Wrong, because this is experience-based testing characteristic. Answer C. They are used both to measure coverage and to design tests to increase coverage. This is correct. This is the main characteristic of structure-based techniques. Let's confirm with answer D. They use a formal or informal model of a software or component. This is wrong, because this is the characteristic of specification-based or black box testing techniques. So the correct answer is C. Question 27. Given the following fragment of code, how many tests are required for 100% decision coverage? This question is best answered by drawing the flowchart of the code. So let's do that together. To answer the question how many test cases are needed to achieve 100% decision coverage, look at the graph. We see we need 4 test cases to cover all the true and false of every if statement. But let's confirm our answer by using actual data. Actually, I encourage you to always try to confirm your answers with using actual data, because sometimes the logic of the code will not help you directly to get test cases. So let's do that in our example. First test case. We need width greater than length and height greater than width. Then we can assume width equals 5, height equals 10, and length equals 1. Second test case, we need width greater than length and height greater than width equals false, meaning we want width greater than height. Then we can assume width equals 10, height equals 5, and length equals 1. Third test case, we need length greater than width and height greater than length. Then we can assume width equals 1, height equals 10, and length equals 5. Fourth test case, we need length greater than width and length greater than height. Then here we can assume width equals 5, height equals 1, and length equals 10. The data makes sense, so our answer A is correct. Another question might be, how many test cases are needed to achieve 100% statement coverage? The answer would be 2. I will leave it up to you to figure out why. How do experience-based techniques differ from specification-based techniques? Answer A. They depend on the tester understanding of the way the system is structured rather than on the documented record of what the system should do. This is wrong, because the tester's understanding of the way the system is structured is about structure-based techniques, not experience-based techniques. Answer B. They depend on having older testers rather than younger testers. This is wrong. Age has nothing to do with specification-based or experience-based techniques. Answer C. They depend on an individual personal view rather than on a documented record of what the system should do. Right. The correct answer should be C. To confirm, let's look at answer D. They depend on a documented record of what the system should do rather than on the individual's personal view. This is wrong. It's the opposite of the correct answer. So the answer here is C. Thank you.